about OS, it recognizes the social base, and it is precisely the social base that it attacks, that it seeks to brutalize to a point where it's completely tired, and so that they can isolate the militancy and finish it off. This is the point that Balogop, a significant point that he makes. This is common to all insurgency, counterinsurgency operations across the world. The Indian state, many people say that the Indian state is learning this from the Sri Lankan government after it managed to wipe out the LTTE. No, this is a tried and tested method of the Indian state. They did it in Mizoram. Friends from the Northeast will know the brutality that they unleashed in Mizoram, where this whole phenomenon called strategic hamletting took place, where entire villages were herded into camps, very much similar to what is happening in the Sarvajanin camps right here in Bastar, in Dantewada, in Bijapur. This is a policy that they've adopted all through, and this cannot go on. If there's anything meaningful about democracy, if there's anything meaningful about addressing issues concerning Adivasis, this cannot be allowed to go on. And any amount of effort is needed towards a political process towards this issue. I will not take too much of your time, there are important speakers coming. But I will simply end by saying, we need not go all the way to Central India. We need not go all the way to Central India to look at corporate takeover of precious resources. We have our own Madhu Kodas within Andhra. We have our own Reddy brothers within Andhra. Except that somehow manages to occupy a lot of media attention and space. But it's happening on a very daily basis within Andhra. And it's interesting, it's amazing that even when the establishment, the state wants to do a good thing, a generous thing, perhaps out of public pressure from below, you know, there's a very disgustingly ugly way, the manner in which they do it. You will recall this incident about Vedanta in Orissa, the company that Anil Agarwal owns. He fancies himself as some kind of a Badshah of bauxite, much like Shah Rukh Khan thinks of himself the Badshah of Bollywood. This person, an NRI sitting in London, thinks he's the Badshah of bauxite. And he's got this big bauxite, you know, gouging operations across the world. And he's laid his eyes on this hill in the Niyamgari forest in Odisha. And the Vedanta company, there was a massive campaign internationally against it. I think some movie was also inspired by it called Cameron's movie. There was some movie, Avatar, was also made. There was a fascinating campaign. And eventually the Forest Strikes Act was invoked, which clearly basically says, without going into details, that unless you settle rights of Adivasis, you cannot divert land for bauxite or whatever, a dam, a power project or whatever. And that had not happened in Vedanta, so the thing was cancelled. The environment clearance, the forest clearance given for Vedanta was cancelled. But the relevant question to be asking is, Rahul Gandhi rushes to Niyamgiri. He makes a stop. He flies to Vishakhapatnam, and the people who meet him in Vishakhapatnam are who? The very people who are behind bauxite operations in Vishakhapatnam.